As the gods and heroes of the classical world faded before the triumph of the church, so new explanations for the existence of huge fossilized bones took their place. This time, they were derived from the Bible. Of course, the scholars of the Middle Ages, like the philosophers and biologists of ancient Greece, had no real idea just how ancient life on Earth really was. But they weren't wholly lacking a notion of a vanished age that had belonged to beings larger and more exotic than themselves. These creatures, like the heroes of ancient Greece, were human, colossally human. Giants. But where had these giants gone? The answer to that, so people in the Middle Ages believed, was to be found in the greatest cataclysm ever to afflict humanity, Noah's flood. Now, the animals may have gone in two by two, but not everyone got out of the rain. There were giants in the earth in those days. So we're told in Genesis, the first book of the Bible, about the world that preceded Noah's flood. And sometimes, in the course of exploration or of excavation, people would find the bones of these same giants. Augustine was one of the first, but certainly not the last, to explain fossils in terms of the flood. In 1342, for instance, a cave was discovered in southern Italy that contained the skeleton of a man 400 feet tall, or so we are told by the great medieval writer Boccaccio. To display their discovery to posterity, the citizens of Trapani strung the bones on a wire and carried them to a church. Not every wonder discovered in rock, however, was to be explained as the relic of a vanished giant. What, for instance, were good Christians to make of mysterious footprints like these? We now know that these bird-like tracks discovered in Oxfordshire were left by the ancestors of carnivorous dinosaurs like Tyrannosaurus. But it's no wonder that back in the Middle Ages, when similar prints were discovered in locations ranging from Poland to the Alps, that some rather diabolical explanations should have been provided. "Whence comest thou?" God asks Satan in the Bible. Back comes the answer: "From going to and fro in the earth, and from walking up and down in it." Indeed, so closely associated with the devil were the footprints of prehistoric creatures that it was not unknown for attempts to be made to neutralize their malign power by incorporating them into the fabric of a church, as here at Bebbington in Cheshire.